Fusion fam, this podcast is scheduled for one take. We know from Houston, Texas, from Texas, the new mouth of the South, Jeremy Brown, the behemoth of Taku Chad Forbes. Together, we are Fusion High.
Gentlemen,
man, we are back, and guess what we're talking about today?
Wrestling!
It's another wrestling episode, baby!
It's like we got like a season for this or whatever. Yeah, like we do like video games here, anime here. But I feel like anime is like around like early winter.
Yeah, it's funny, as I'm walking up, that's when all the anime comes out. This year gonna be good.
Oh, wow.
But yeah, man. Well, I'm Chad.
And I'm Jeremy.
And together, this podcast, this team, this collective, we make Fusion.
I gotta flex one time.
All right, man. So, this podcast.
The audio on this
podcast. This podcast, man, the wrestling world has been a booming baby.
I am wrestling.
This, yes. Oh my God, wrestling has been so amazing these past couple of months, bro. Yes. Oh man. So, we haven't talked about wrestling in a while. It has been a while. And a lot has happened. That's why we had to do a wrestling episode.
Funny because we did one with Chris.
We kind of tiptoed around certain things, but now we're about to dive in.
Oh my God,
man! So, oh my God. The news that shook the wrestling world to its core: Vince McMahon.
See, I'm a what? Vince McMahon?
Oh man, that's a huge. I don't know which one is. Hey, I bet you if the CM Punk thing would happen the same time as Vince thing, well, nobody would even care about Vince McMahon.
I don't know. I think the world would caught on fire like because of the friction.
Oh yeah, man. So Vince McMahon retired on his own free will.
That was the day we went to that Kendrick Lamar concert. Yep. That was on Friday.
Yep. He said that I'm 77. I'm out, bro. Y'all got it. basically in a nutshell, Vince McMahon retired, and that put the wrestling world into a frenzy, because this is Vince McMahon. Vince McMahon has been synonymous with wrestling as long as I've been watching wrestling.
I'm 35. I've been watching since I was 12, like I said.
Yeah. As long as I've been watching wrestling, I've been watching Vince McMahon.
Yeah.
Being him being commentary to being the big bad boss man, no pun intended. He retired. Now, if this was his own, under his own doing, or due to allegations he got going on in his life, I don't know.
Man,
we all know.
We ain't no journalists. Yeah. So we all fuck know. All that. We know why he out here, bro.
Yeah,
we know he out of here.
Quick, the evidence was piling up.
This podcast.
And the evidence was stacking up like these pops, bro. It was stacking, so they was like, yeah, Vince, you have to go, bro.
There you go. That's what I want to hear. There you go.
You know, it's stacking the evidence. Stacking up. Oh, you did this? You did that, too?
They knew.
And while you were retiring, something else came out, too? Like, dang, bro. You
see the meme talking about he paid less for WCW than he did for pussy. I said, God dang.
I hate the internet, bro. I hate the internet.
It's true.
That's funny, bro. Oh, my God. That is hilarious. But man, Vince McMahon was apparently out here balling, but allegedly balling, but I don't know why anybody is surprised, because, I mean, do y'all not remember the stuff we saw from Vince growing up as a kid.
As Mr. McMahon.
Yeah, and I remember the whole Linda McMahon paralyzed, muted, and in a wheelchair.
WrestleMania 17.
Making out with Trish. Like, we all don't remember that, right?
Ooh, slapping it down.
Yeah. Like, come on. This guy's wild. But yeah, man, so that happened, and man, the wrestling world was just, we didn't know what was going to happen. But then,
I was disappointed, actually.
You were? And him retired? Yeah.
Boy, I thought he was going to be on that ship as it sinks, saluting.
Yep.
And
he got no playing the violin.
Yeah, man. Him on his, and he's the last thing you see in this, yep. And the bubbles
yep.
stop,
because
man.
It was dying. Because WWE, it needed something, bro. It was just, it was like yeah. stale, moldy, crusty bread, bro. It was nasty.
And I'm guilty of saying yeah. that. Like, I think last year, I was talking that hottest of all
hot shit on this podcast. Anytime I would ask you about watching the WWE pay-per-view, it's like, I spin your face.
Man, I felt very insulted. Yeah. Like, man, that shit mad trash, man. Yeah, same matches 75 times.
You ain't lying. But, man, then all of a sudden, something came from the sky. From the heavens,
mm-hmm.
and it came down, and you know what it said?
I am the game.
It's time to play the game. I'm Triple H,
and I'm gonna give it to ya.
Woo, man! Triple H, who? I mean, we all saw what Triple H did with NXT, bro. He put NXT. He put, as Triple H says, his developmental show.
Oh, that's petty. We're going to get there in a
minute. He took his little developmental show and made it big business.
Yeah.
Man, nobody was checking MCW like that back in the day, bro. Nobody was looking for that. But NXT, black and gold?
Ooh.
Oh, he was there for that. And, man, Triple H pushed it to the limit, man. Gave us some of the bright, shining stars we see today out here.
And life happened.
Yeah.
He had, I'm going to say heart attack, but they say cardiac.
He had a cardiac event.
His heart was like, man, I'm tired.
And then, you know, Vince was upset that he lost the AEW in the ratings. So he took NXT and threw glitter on
he
it.
He watched somebody play Splatoon in the locker room.
He watched Splatoon, glitter, all paint, everything. And we got NXT 2.0. And then everybody tuned out and stopped watching it because... And you know what's crazy? NXT 2.0 does have some good wrestlers on there.
True.
Like Cameron, I'm a big fan of Cameron Brown. That's my boy. And Carmelo, too. Yeah.
Who the Asian chick in the onesie?
Oh, I don't know. That's silly.
That is all kinds of Vince McMahon from 95.
That's some.
We talking about the Goon. Man. No, that ain't even the Goon better than that. We talking about Repo Man.
That's weird, bro. That's weird. But, man, now, Triple H, and it's funny because whenever you see people that go into, like, with a job, they get a new vice president, even like in the presidency of the world, like now, like the actual president and things like that,
right.
It takes time for their changes to be noticed. And most of the time, it's noticed after they're gone. But Triple H's, presence, was felt almost immediately.
Yeah, almost.
Because it pretty much happened right before, which pay-per-view was that? SummerSlam? Yeah, right before SummerSlam, like, it was kind of the same, but then...
Yeah, you just signed up loose ends, I get that.
Yeah, but man, that Monday night, that boy came in hot.
He started it, but he launched.
Yeah.
And after that, he kept going. And like, you know, I heard some stuff and I kind of listened to, you know, what some of these guys saying. I was like, well, you know, like, come on, get that man a break. You know, like, oh, that episode was kind of but it was still good. You know, better than Vince. And it was like, oh, yeah, I was like, this is not Vince.
I am a Vincent McMahon guy because, I mean, we all were. Like, we all grew up on WWE.
20-some years ago,
but we all grew up on that.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to think, WWE just... It was hot trash a couple of months ago. I mean, a couple months ago. But now, man, it's night and day. It's like, it's going back. I won't say attitude era greatness, but it's
early 2010. It's good. It's good. Yeah. It's I enjoy seeing the returns and the way they're doing it. Like, for instance,
yes,
with the whole Dexter Lumis thing. Bro, the Dexter Lumis thing is one of the greatest
things. That dude's kidnapping grown men. What the hell are we doing?
Oh, my God, bro. It's one of the greatest things ever. This man kidnapped the Miz. The grown Miz. Put this man through the ring, and this man is seeing.
Yo, that was a great visual, man. Like, it was a cage match, right?
Yeah.
And, like, Miz tried to climb out, and then Dexter Lumis
just was sitting there looking, like, boop.
That face was perfect.
Yeah.
I was like, who told him to make that face?
And so, if you remember, you remember when his first, like, when he first came back.
Yeah, they showed some stuff, like, I think, what was it, like, on the internet or whatever? Yeah.
So, it was, that night of Monday Night Raw, yes, they showed, like, so people were talking, whatever, and you could see, it was some people talking about a car crash, like a car wreck.
Oh, okay.
And the police and stuff were sitting there, and some wrestlers in the back are talking to, you know, the police and stuff like that. That never happens. Like, WWE, WWE is very contained. Like, they're only letting you look at whatever they want you to look at. Like, if somebody does something crazy in the crowd, like, they're not going to sit there and pull, like, if someone runs
camera
in the
ring, please.
Yeah, they're not going to focus on that person. They're going to shift that camera wherever it has to go.
Yep.
So, they showed that. They showed, you know, stuff on fire and stuff like that. And then, that last night, there was a hooded man in the crowd trying to jump over the barricade, and you could see Dexter Lumis, but you could see that mustache.
He's in the mustache.
You can see him, and then the way they're doing him is masterful. Look who at how many people they brought back, man. They brought back Braun Strowman. That's the one.
Control your narrative.
CYN, Mr. CYN himself. That boy controlled his narrative, all right. He dumped that. He got rid of him immediately. Like, hey,
you see that?
I'm letting WWE control my narrative over here.
Did you see the meme? It was like a picture of Will Smith in a house and it was empty, talking about EC3 and controlling his narrative. He's just by himself in an empty building. Like, oh,
that's
shit.
Funny.
I say, EC3 looking sick.
Man, he gotta be sick.
And they should have a meme of speaking of Fresh Prince of Bel-Air with Uncle Phil and Will, and EC3 put his head on there. Why he don't want me, man? Talk about WWE. Because he ain't going back to WWE. Oh, Triple H's like, yeah, I love CYN, but I want Braun Strowman, though.
Yeah, just Braun. You can do something with that guy.
They brought back Johnny Wrestling.
He came back?
I hear,
I seen that.
Oh, man. Yeah, bro.
He need to be there. He's good.
Yeah.
You know, they can do great things with Johnny Wrestling.
Yeah. I feel like WWE.
Not him. I'm thinking about? Fucking guy with million names. Johnny Mundo, Johnny Impact. I forgot.
Oh,
Johnny Gargano. I know about that. My bad. Yeah. Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah. I feel like WWE is trying to right their wrongs for everybody who they released over the past couple of, maybe the past year.
Couple years.
But people that shouldn't even left, like Tommaso Ciampa, even though he's still with the company, they used him so bad.
Man, he was on Superstars or some crap like that.
This man is a beast, and you got him wrestling on Superstars?
Man,
even though Superstars still event, came on.
Main event of Superstars.
Yeah, I ain't know either one of them came on.
No, nobody watches that. That's why.
Yeah.
Mike, and that was Vince doing.
I feel like he just really had it out for Triple H's, any of Triple H's creations. He just had it out for him. It is evident now. It is evident. Because Triple H is bringing him back. Like, if it was what was best for business, if that's truly what it was, and budget cuts and stuff like that. But I think I know what budget cuts were really used for, but that's the topic for another day.
Just pay them losses.
Yep. I think.
Pay for them ladies.
Yep. Imagine getting let go. Oh my God. Anyway,
by $20 million on some gooch.
Man, imagine seeing I just got let go and this come out. Oh, right. I'm fighting. But yeah, like that dude, that idiot doing that picture.
Yeah, like, come on.
Me? This your boy. It's your boy, Braun.
Oh, man.
Man, bro. Oh, this is wild.
Oh, yeah.
It's so wild. But I'm really happy that these people have come back, man.
Oh, for sure.
And I like seeing. I'm happy to see Bayley and now it's Damage Control. Now they finally got a name because They were fumbling. Like, I didn't know what they had.
He was kind of rusty. I can watch one match with her. She was rusty.
Yeah, yeah, well, Bayley ain't rusty though.
Wow. Damn near. So, no, I ain't giving the, I ain't going to be like, man, she should be better than that. Nah.
Yeah,
I get it. I ain't mad at it. Because I watched, I said, ooh, that women's matches. Stank.
Yeah.
I said, all these girls are good. What the hell happened today?
Yeah. But I'm super happy that, like I said, for everyone coming back, I am liking the direction that WWE has gone in as far as the bloodline. The bloodline is becoming... I see, this is a stable that I like. I like stables like this that are dumb. Like, I don't see anybody just defeating the bloodline except for the bloodline. That's the only way
I see it. And it blows.
Yeah, that's the only way I see it.
I get you.
Going anywhere. And I feel like Sami Zayn is going to be the catalyst of it.
Them memes, though. Oh, like him tweeting or whatever, man. Yeah.
Oh, Sami, man, national treasure, bro. Protect him at all costs.
Oh, yeah.
Sami Zayn is hilarious, man.
Some of what's best for business had me thinking about, like, FTR should have won it from the Bucks.
Yes. I mean, look at the man's shirt. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's FTW. I thought I said FTR.
Nah, man.
We'll put an R in there for today. Yeah, man.
Since 87, man. I've been saying that my damn self. Go ahead.
That's funny. Oh, yeah, I don't know why. Well, I know why now. But I could never. I didn't understand why.
Well, you see what now.
Yeah, I see a lot of stuff now.
Because, you know, how do you do timeless classics with the same tag team months apart from each other, you know? FTR versus the Briscoes. Everybody wants to go see them.
Yep.
Just saying.
Yep.
Just saying.
The man, FTR, they them dudes, man. They are attraction. They are attraction.
I love watching them. Watching them, man. Yeah. Or even like, what was it, Jay Lethal versus, I keep forgetting his name, my wife called him Mr. Monopoly. Dax Harwood. He fought somebody else, and I was like, man. Claudio.
Yeah.
On Rampage.
Yeah.
Oh my God, that was good. That's wrestling.
They tout him as being one of the best wrestlers on the planet. They tout him as that.
But his idol, you know who his idol is, right?
Yeah, my old Brett.
Brett.
Yep.
Song with our boy CM Punk. That's why they all three of them respect each other.
Yeah.
They're best friends.
Oh, okay.
They're
best
friends because of that. Yeah.
Yep. Kyle, that's a good thing to be bonded over.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't know why FTR aren't the tag team champions. I don't see them being tag team champions. Let me see. No, it's going to be a little while for them to be tag team champions. Well, I don't know. So people are on vacation. So they may get the belt now. Who knows? I don't know.
Because we know why they're not.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that.
Which is wild.
Those guys are suspended, too.
That's right.
Best for business, right?
Yeah. Oh, you're petty. Mm. Yeah, man. That's still wild. Mm. Your EVPs have been suspended. Like, you don't see that happen, bro. You don't even see that happen too wild.
Now,
it'd have to be some heinous, crazy stuff.
Yeah. I know it was, you know, talking about wrestling, dude.
Yeah. For that's kind of funny. Wrestlers getting suspended for fighters. Wow. Like, I watched Kenny Omega and John Moxley hit each other with barbed wire bats and whatever they were beating each other up with.
Explosion.
Oh, that explosion was nasty. Oh my God. I still remember Eddie Kingston dived over him. I was like, what are you doing? I can't imagine that conversation on the crowd. Do you see this?
What the hell is this?
Don't see anything. That's the problem.
What the hell is that? What? Okay.
Yeah, man.
Eddie Kingston was supposed to play the role of Terry Funk.
Man.
I seen that match. I actually watched. Yeah. I watched that. Like the original match was, I think, Onita and Terry. Yeah, I watched it.
That was funny.
Yeah.
So, but yeah.
Oh my gosh.
So, man, have you been watching any WWE lately?
I can't watch 3 hours of that stuff. I can't do Mondays because I gotta go to bed. I gotta go like 4:20 in the morning. And no, not for that 4:20 stuff. You know, ain't no wake and bake. None of that goofiness. You are covering me, dude, on the camera.
Man.
Oh,
man.
Well, at least the audio can hear me. But Ricochet's winning matches.
Yeah.
See that.
He just had a good match against Sami Zayn the other day.
I ain't watched it.
Oh, bro.
Oh, yeah. I told mom off dinner. That's why I ain't watching no wrestling. As a matter of fact, on Friday. But yeah, he is winning.
Yeah, he's winning.
He's okay. winning.
And he is still the cold-blooded Ricochet that we know and love.
I was like, Ricochet, fucking run to AEW. There's a spot for you. I know yeah. there is.
Man, I don't know if I want that anymore, to be honest.
Well, now.
I don't know if I want that, to be honest, because I just feel like he's going to be overshadowed because AEW has a roster problem as far as...
Yes, I agree.
They need another show or Rampage needs another hour. It needs something.
Ring of Honor. There you go. AEW
needs a Ring of Honor. Instead of having
Tony's Ring of Honor.
Well, hey, well, you know, I mean, Colt Cabana's on the roster, so there'll be some other wrestlers on there soon, right?
He'll just get let go again. Let's keep it 100. Was he really touching the needle to even push it?
Nah.
There you go. Hey, sorry, Colt. Seem like a nice guy, but come on, dude. Nobody coming here to see you.
Hey, man, Dark Order.
I'd rather see Johnny Hungy, baby!
Johnny Hungy, oh,
that boy looked like a small dwarf, man.
Yeah, man, that boy, yeah, he be getting busy.
He does get busy, though. See how we talk about him? Cole, what you been doing, bro? Saying.
There was that one time when he...
You watch Dark? Or Dark Elevation?
No.
I watch that when I wash my ass. I put that on my daddy's grave. I watch that when I wash my rubber duck when I remember to. Alright? No offense, Tony. Hey,
you saw Coco Bat. What was he doing? He was going wild.
No, I didn't even watch him. Oh. I seen other matches.
Did you fast forward through that?
Boy. I didn't. When he ever on?
Open your eyes and heard that theme music. Oh, nope. Nope.
I'm just saying, dude. I don't watch, man.
Punk, we're giving you free material. You're welcome.
Yeah, you're welcome, bro.
Yeah, man.
Remember Chad and Jeremy?
Oh my god, that's funny. Yeah, bro.
We don't hate you, it's just
man. So you say you haven't really, you've been watching WWE.
I'm on and off with it, like, yeah. Like, cause like I said, man, that was a bad taste in my mouth. And I'm talking about like 2 years ago, man, and even before that, you know, like I said, Rusev at the time, instead of Miro, that left a bad taste in my mouth, man. And then like just like everything above, you know, around it, and I was like, I can't. I just can't. You booking these guys insanely stupid.
Yeah, but it's not really so much like that anymore. Like,
oh, no.
Kevin Owens has gone back to being the prize fighter Kevin Owens. Like, and that's the Kevin Owens.
The promos.
Yeah. Oh, promos. Man. Promo. God, dude. He's
good.
Man, he's one of the best at doing promos. Something else good about WWE now, too. Something else they're doing. What? People are getting their names back.
I heard.
Austin Theory is yeah. Austin Theory, not just Theory anymore.
Yeah.
Matt Riddle is Matt. Not Riddle anymore. Yeah. He's Matt Riddle.
Oh my like, god. Like, how do you have? They're using the word wrestler. They're using the word wrestler. Yes, oh not superstar or sports entertainer. Wrestler.
Yep. And.
And wrestling.
Yep. And something cool is that. So Drew and. Drew and Kevin Owens had a match.
Oh.
And they were sitting there going back and forth cutting promos on each other. And Drew McIntyre says this and the place exploded. And I wasn't gonna say I exploded in my living room, but that'd be kinda wild, right? I popped hard in my living room.
Ah, there you go.
At the fact of him saying, "This is a wrestling company, so let's freaking wrestle." I was like, oh my god, yes, finally!
Man, that's crazy.
Yeah,
that is crazy.
Yeah, man, and bro, I'm just so excited.
That's crazy.
For WWE going back to being the WWE that starting working its way back to being the WWE that I grew up with and loved. Because I didn't know.
Triple H made sense again. That's all it was.
Storylines are actual storylines. It's not, I don't have to look at the 24/7 champion looking like a Benny Hill movie. Like,
I read that.
Just watch Google Benny Hill if you don't know what it is. But Like, it's just so, man, that was just so bad, man. It was.
Yo, they getting a little edgy too, man, with Seth and Matt Riddle. Remember that?
Oh my God.
That was a great promo. Yeah.
So,
that was a great promo. Yeah, man,
that was. And you know what's so crazy? Like I said before on the other podcast that we just did. Wrestling is good when you sprinkle a little bit of real life in there.
Yeah.
You sprinkle a little bit because if you remember, Seth Rollins and Matt Riddle had beef beef.
Yeah, yeah, they had some real, yeah, realistic
issues. Matt Riddle or Matt Riddle's ex-wife now was talking bad about the women's wrestlers of WWE.
Yeah.
Even though she ain't a wrestler, I ain't talking about it, but whatever. And you know, talking about Becky Lynch, talking about like she wasn't like in good shape and stuff like that. And Matt Riddle, and Matt Riddle chimed in on it and stuff like that. And he's like, bro, you gotta go to work on Monday. Guess who's gonna be there? Seth Rollins
and Becky.
Yep. Why are you talking about my girl like that? Yeah. Like, that's disrespectful. Like, you're not letting we not gonna do that.
It's kind of like Cage's wife was talking shit about, you know, like how he wasn't getting booked, you know, in AEW. You know, I think it was like last year, and it was like. And I remember Botchamania posted like so many stuff. He even went for like the AEW championship. Like, what the fuck are you talking about? He's pretty decent or whatever, but it was like, oh, they did book him.
Yeah, they booked him.
Like you said, they just have an issue when it comes to all these goddamn wrestlers. So I get it. It's like so many people that can be on TV this week. You know, because you can kind of like, you know, alternate them if you're not a book, right?
Yeah.
But it's like, nah, shut up. Tell your wife to shut the fuck up about a goddamn business.
Yeah, you out here making me look bad at work.
Man, what you doing?
But yeah, that's why that Seth Rollins and Matt Riddle thing
is
so crazy to see them like, because Seth Rollins was like, I will never work with Matt Riddle. That's what you said back then. I remember reading the interview. Yeah. It's like, I'm not going to work with him. But I'm sure they squashed it behind the scenes.
Yeah, by that time.
I'm sure they squashed it. And now it's like, we're starting to bring some real life elements because we're already over it. So let's do it.
Yeah,
it is working because, man, that match that they just had the last pay per view at Clash of the Castle.
I heard Clash of the Castle was great.
Oh, that pay per view was kind of hard, bro. I'm not gonna lie.
Man, that was right before AEW's.
Yep. Oh, man. Did you hear Speaking of that, so we just talked about this too. We talked about how. AEW, one of the first wrestling companies to have the whole medium scrum press conference, mumbo jumbo, you know, after.
Yes.
So, guess who else started doing that?
WWE.
Yeah.
Sound like to me.
And Tony Khan was furious.
Yeah, all I heard about
was mad.
That.
He was mad that they did the pay per view the same weekend.
Yeah.
And he was like, I'm not going to sit down and take this. Tony Khan was going off.
Yeah.
So,
man.
I'm like,
Hurt his feelings.
But my thing is, that's cool, Tony. I'm happy you're passionate about that. I actually respect that. But why didn't you have that passion when you were sitting next to CM Punk and he was bashing everybody?
Now, wait a minute. That's CM Punk, man.
No.
Come on. That should go to
what's bigger, WWE or CM Punk?
But you don't knock your goose. That
I understand
go
that.
Next.
But
you give WWE
potentially, yeah, you're right. You have the power to, but they ain't never going to drive AEW out of business. But they have the power to absorb your business.
That is also true.
If they deem it necessary.
Yep. They will buy your butt off. Man.
Yep.
I only got the money for it.
So that's, even though technically Tony Khan, his dad, got more money than them.
Yeah, oh yeah, I got more money than them.
But it's just a different type of thing.
Yeah, I feel it.
You know, it's just, it's wild, bro. It's wild.
Yeah.
I don't know what's going to come in the wrestling world over these next couple of months. I'm looking to see WWE. I feel like this is they're righting the wrongs, man. They're righting the wrongs of everything.
But you're like, give too much credit just to one company, man. Why are you doing that?
There's
so many companies out there. We're talking about wrestling as a wrestling episode.
Yeah.
What about control your narrative, dude? Come on!
Braun Strowman quit? I don't know.
You don't hate me.
I don't know if anything else he quit. Like, is that the good thing about it? I don't know. Like,
how that conversation went? That's my question.
Oh, I can't even imagine.
Oh my God.
I can just see it. Let me paint the picture for you. You ready?
Oh, man.
So, you know, they were coming here too. I was gonna see if you wanted to go, but I guess we ain't gonna worry about it. But because I want to see what it was about. Like, I remember the rules of reading it, of like, you know, the rules that they have.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that.
I want to see you guys enforce these rules. So, this is how it went, bro. Here, hear me out.
I'm listening.
So, EC3 and Braun Strowman just tore the house down, right?
Okay.
You know, Braun Strowman, man, he lost the match. Dang, that sucks, man.
Yeah.
But I booked myself to lose, but I'm doing it for the fans.
Right.
Braun Strowman walks to the back. EC3 is in the ring. Yeah. Praise me. So he's shaking the fans' hands.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 7. Okay. All right. He's walking to the back because that's not who's always there. So he's walking to the back.
Right.
And Braun Strowman's just sitting there on the phone, arm draped by his side like this.
Yeah.
Yo, Braun, we just tore the house down. You okay? Braun.
Yeah.
I quit. He just walked out. Hey, he's like,
oh shit. Hey, no. I'm dizzy.
Oh, fuck, lips on. Hey,
no.
Oh, goddamn.
Oh, what if it was like this? He's on the phone, arm draped to the side. Yo, Braun, you okay? It's time to play the game. And you haven't seen Braun sick.
He's sick.
Oh my god. Blocked that blood on social media. It's over. You don't know who that is.
Oh, shit.
You see who?
Oh god, I don't see nothing. Oh god.
Oh my god, bro. Oh. But yeah, man.
Oh god.
And you know, up.
Oh god, dang.
Up until
I quit, bro.
Up until this craziness with AEW.
Oh god, damn.
Up until this craziness with AEW. Things have been going pretty good with AEW, man. We finally got Punk to come back.
Right.
Punk and Moxley cut this promo against each other.
Oh,
which was insane. But I will say, you know, I'm a CM Punk fan, but there's one thing I didn't like when CM Punk first came back, when he first initially came back.
Mm-hmm.
When he was in the ring talking about Moxley away, waiting for him to come down. CM Punk's in the ring doing Snow Angels.
Yo, that was funny though.
No, see, I thought it was funny too. Until Punk lost and like he got squashed.
Oh, that.
Like, I was like, no, we're not doing
Snow. No. That's when he first came back. Then remember they was like, we'll do it at the pay-per-view.
Yeah.
But then next week, we gonna have him fight. Remember?
Yeah.
So, okay. Good promos here and there. And then it's like, fuck it, we'll just fight. Because remember, like, now one thing I really like about that episode, when Punk came back, and it was a complaint that, like, I remember listening to, I always reference, like, Jim Cornette and them, like, you know, they always watched, they actually watched it, you know? And it was a big complaint that they made, which, remember, they used to watch this in WWE, or Elf at the time. Those reoccurring events with the same wrestlers, all the way, either it led to the main event, remember, they had, like, the first, like, 10, 15 minutes of guys talking, you know, got this beef, or, you know, going by from, like, Raw, SmackDown. Beating each other up in the backstage. Like, hey, we're gonna handle it in the ring. You know, it was on and on. And that's what they did. That's a great thing. And then let's go to next week to the part that you didn't like. Carry on. I did like that episode when you first came back.
Yeah. So to me, I didn't like that in hindsight because it's like you're CM Punk. You got squashed. Like, what was the reason for you even being squashed like that? Like, cause
I guess a pay-per-view. I don't know specifically why.
Yeah, and so it was so weird and random because Jon Moxley's the champion.
Yes.
Which
he became
champion. And that's cool.
That's good.
But he lost it the next week. Four days later.
Yeah.
For it only to be vacated again. But now, to be fair, the vacated again part. Nobody saw that. We didn't see that coming.
Stuff happened, right?
Yeah. It was a little wild. AEW was going a little crazy.
You know, kids be kids, right?
Yeah.
My favorite meme was one you posted with Stone Cold Steve Austin. Dave, where's it at, man?
Oh, when you was talking about, so.
Oh, man, you ready? I want to do it. Let's see. Okay, you hear me on the thing? All right. Yeah. It's like, I love that, by the way. The picture of him at the Broken Skull Sessions, right? It's like, you made your big comeback, lose the AEW title to Jon Moxley, win it back 4 days later, hell of a match. Then you cut a promo at the press club calling Hangman Page a fuckhead, and you slap the piss out of the Young Bucks, and I'm like, God damn, the kid is working or is he shooting? And everybody that commented on that post on Instagram was like, I read it just how Stone Cold
was reading Stone Cold's voice.
And I did. Oh my God.
You gotta read it in his voice. Man.
Best meme so far, in my opinion. I mean, there's others that killed it, but still.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, these memes been fire, bro. Oh my God. All right, so Jeremy, we're talking about wrestling and things like that.
Yes.
I'm gonna jump back to WWE and go back to AEW.
It's a wrestling episode. Yeah, my wrestling in general.
So, what would you like to see from WWE going forward?
Oh wow.
Yeah.
WWE going forward. I need to start watching more of it. Foremost, to kind of catch up with some of the stuff. But I mean, I watch reviews.
Yeah.
You know what? I got it. The biggest thing to me, and I know even Triple H said this before, and I don't know if he had the power to do it, but I know it's making the money. I want Raw to go back to 2 hours.
2 hours? Really? How come?
It's not always great for 3 hours. It's so much writing. There's so much stuff you can do within 3 hours, right? But like back when, a lot of fans, even like the old ones, you know, we like the Attitude Era, obviously, and even the Ruthless Aggression time.
Mm-hmm.
It's only 2 hours. Boom. Short and sweet. And it ain't that short. It's just like within that time frame, you can do a lot. Less is more, you know? And the way I look at it is like, yeah, less is more. And even like, you know, if you watch people lose, like, I think it's like an hour and 45 minutes. I get it that, you know, they're cutting a couple matches out. But if you think about it, a lot of it is commercials anyway. So, I mean, they're making money off of advertisement. And, like, I get that. But it's like, it's only so much you can do. Why you think they had, like, a 24-7 champion?
Yeah.
You know, because it's like, damn, we got to fill this extra hour. We got to put something in. And it's like, it's only so much you can do. And I got to go to bed, dude. I'm tired,
That's
dude.
The thing. So, I was in Pennsylvania, right? Mm-hmm. Man, Raw came on at 8 o'clock.
Yeah. Well, it used to. Remember back in the day, it used to come on at 8, you know.
They came on at 8 o'clock. So, you, that means.
So, it's not, wait, would it be like. Oh, yeah.
It came on at 8. Yeah.
Yeah,
it came on at 8.
Yeah.
So, that means I'm up till 11 o'clock.
Yep.
I want to be up there late watching wrestling. I'm going to go to sleep. I'm going to go to work. Luckily, I don't live there.
Yeah, luckily you live in Central Time instead of Eastern Time.
But that was, man, I'm like, bro, that sucks, man.
I feel bad for the New Yorkers, man. The New York people on the East Coast.
And you know what's funny?
Yeah.
And wrestling is super big up there, so everybody stays up late.
Yeah.
It don't matter.
Florida Time, too. Yeah. My wife's grandmother used to watch Raw, along with my mother-in-law. So I was like, Jesus Christ. Like, nah, she's like, unhealthy or anything like that, but like, you sit until 11 o'clock watching that stuff?
Yeah.
Good God, lady.
Yeah, man.
Wow.
Yeah, man. One thing I do want to see from WWE going forward, I like how I feel about Brock Lesnar. You know, I love Brock Lesnar.
Okay.
And I come to like Braun Strowman. He was fairly new. But Braun Strowman I like Braun Strowman. He's really good.
Okay.
But I don't want to see anybody be champion again that's a part-timer or so big and so powerful they just run through everyone. I want to see different people be champions again. I miss those things.
So what about what we got now?
Now see, Roman Reigns. But see, there's a difference though.
Okay, carry on.
Is that Roman Reigns hasn't really just destroyed, like, he hasn't squashed anybody.
Yeah.
Roman Reigns really just started becoming a part-timer. He just started.
Yeah, I know.
It's fairly new.
I know.
So I'm not tripping on that. And we're only going to have another couple of months of it because I feel like somewhere between now and then he's going to lose the belt. Some people thinking it's going to be to The Rock. I'm thinking Cody Rhodes. That's what I'm thinking.
I'm hearing that they're going to try to keep it on him to WrestleMania to fight The Rock.
Yeah.
That's what I was hearing.
So that means
that's my source. Yeah. Russell talking. They got other sources. Yeah. So that means
The Rock is gonna go for the belt,
possibly.
And then The Rock's gonna win the belt.
Don't know.
Okay.
Question mark. Right.
Yeah.
How do you write that? And then right now we're in September. How the hell we get to April?
Yeah, because that's you question, still got right? Austin Theory with the Money in the Bank.
Oh.
Yeah. Money in the Bank briefcase that is sucked on cashing in because he get derailed every time.
I see.
So I don't know what's going to go, but I want to see other people. And I mentioned it before on the podcast when Seth Rollins was going against Roman Reigns for the belt. I was happy and hoping that because Roman Reigns had technically never beat Seth Rollins, right, at the time?
Ooh.
I don't think so. So
I
was like, man, hopefully the streak can go on. The boy win the belt. Yeah. So Seth Rollins can eventually be able to lose. Because Seth Rollins is the book the same way as Roman Reigns, where he's invincible. But Roman Reigns has the bloodline.
Yeah, and that's what the book is so good, too. Yeah.
And that's what's different too about Roman Reigns is that he has the Usos, honorary Usos, Sami Zayn, Paul Heyman. And now Solo Sikoa, like you have all these people.
A brother, right?
Yeah,
right,
you
right.
got all these people that can help you out. So Roman Reigns just ain't destroying everybody, making everybody look bad. Like, I still never forgive Brock Lesnar or what he did to Randy Orton in that title match. Still never letting that go. Do you remember what he did?
He bust his head open the hallway.
Yeah, Roman Reigns. I mean, Randy Orton like trash. And that's Randy Orton.
They agree to that. And Jericho got pissed.
Yeah,
he was pissed. He was like, what the heck?
And yeah, like, what are you doing?
That they planned that. Yeah. But he didn't know.
Yeah. So, that's what I want to see. I want to see other people be champions and just not the same monotonous thing. But
it makes the belt look pretty prestigious.
Yeah,
though,
yeah.
Like, you got to be the creme de la creme of the goddamn company to sit there and get to be real. In order to be the man, you gotta beat the man, Ric Flair.
Yep.
Come on now.
Woo!
Come on now.
I know. But they need to separate the belts as well. That's something else I want to see.
That's not that. I know that's
so
like,
that way they could be champions on different shows.
I agree.
Because give me the last five champions over the past maybe 2 or 3 years in WWE.
2 years. Roman been holding it for 2 years damn near.
I'm gonna say five. We'll say five.
Oh, gosh.
Oh.
Kofi's one of them.
Oh, you think? Okay. Kofi. Daniel. Oh, Brian.
Strongman.
Braun. Drew.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, Drew needed it back.
Yeah.
Because we see him in the COVID era.
Yep.
So
with no fans.
And
there's been five or six champions in 5 years, bro.
Yeah.
That is insane.
Yeah.
Insane. Oh, Big E.
Poor thing. Yeah. Got injured. Yeah.
Yeah, man. So it hadn't really been a lot of champions running around. And then when they had the belt split open, it was just Roman and Brock holding the belts. Like, there was nobody.
They held it hostage. You're right.
So I want to see different people be champions. I love seeing other people get opportunities to see if they can shine. Like, I feel like Liv Morgan is like an experiment right now.
Oh, yeah.
She's another experiment.
She is.
Least, I want to see her. I don't know if she's going to beat Ronda. I'm doubting it, to be honest. Don't think she's going to win. I didn't think she was going to beat... Well, actually, I'll take that back. I kind of knew she was going to beat... what's her name? Why am I spacing her name? Lady who she just fought. MMA lady. I saw you, DeVille.
What's her name? God, a tough-looking chick.
It'll come to me.
Spade.
Oh, yeah, the Queen of Spades.
Yeah, I've got a name. Oh, my God.
Wow, this is embarrassing.
Shayna Baszler.
Shayna Baszler. Could not think of her name.
Yeah.
Holy crap. I knew that Liv Morgan was going to win just because it sucks how I figured this, but they don't book Shayna right. Like,
dude. Like, they needed her right when she was in that, what was that cage match?
The Elimination Chamber? When she eliminated everyone?
She killed and destroyed everybody in like minutes. That's the only time I was like, okay, that's believable.
Yeah.
Because her background and how she is.
But now.
But that, we're not.
No. is just, she's just nothing, bro. Yep. And I don't like that. So I knew Liv Morgan was gonna win, but Ronda, I don't see her beating Ronda another time.
But getting back to like the hit the main champions, you know, I should say Roman.
Yeah.
The way they're doing it is perfect. So like now it's like though you're saying like, oh, you want to see other people hold the belts. Nah, you shouldn't like just pass the belt around like it's, you know, like it's something to do.
Yeah.
The way they're doing it right now, I dig it. Because you got, like I said, you gotta be that motherfucker to like sit there and hold that mug on me, and you know, not just hold it, but like also have like timeless classics, man. Yeah. Like you can't just be some scrub, like, cause we seen scrubs with belts before, yeah, man. And that's the thing, like Bruno Sammartino, Hulk Hogan.
Yeah. Yeah,
and Roman Reigns, yep. JBL, these guys held the motherfuckers for a long time.
And I am one of the people that love Roman Reigns' reign. Like, yeah. I think it's dope. Like,
yeah.
Cause I'm a big Roman Reigns fan.
Right.
A lot of people trash Roman because he was forced down our throats. I just always thought he was cool.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
Yeah.
But Roman Reigns was still probably like one of my most improved wrestlers ever in the history of wrestling. Like,
I got a question.
No, I'm just saying. Like, he's just one of my most improved wrestlers ever in wrestling. So the fact that he's gotten to this point and is this great, like,
yeah.
I feel like he is finally comfortable. Like, comfortable.
And he owned
his character so well.
Yeah. Man. Oh, yeah, man. Especially that media thing for the Crown Jewel. Jesus Christ. He killed that. You showed me that video?
Oh, my God.
I mean, in other ones before that, I'm like, acknowledge me. And it walked off, and I was
But sometimes that's all you need.
Less is more, bro.
Like, you talking about the I didn't sing you on the Crown Jewel one. I sent you that one.
Yeah, you showed me that one.
Okay. You talking about the one I sent you when that reporter was talking to him?
Yeah.
And you just sitting there.
Yeah. He was quiet.
I was waiting for you to acknowledge me, but you didn't. So I'm out. And he left. Oh my God, that is amazing. Yes,
and it wasn't that much. Less is more. I got two things to say. We talking about wrestling. Because, like, really, that's why I was like, no finish, because it's, like, totally on topic.
So, yeah, go ahead.
So, I agree with CM Punk. I know, going back to that media thing.
Yeah.
That is very arrogant of anybody who goes, I don't need any advice. And I am freaking happy that CM Punk brought that out. And I mean,
don't
Hangman and Adam Page. But dude, you're too fucking arrogant to say that.
No.
And Chris said this here in this room, you already feel like you learned everything about wrestling, get out.
You get inspiration from, like, let's say, anything and everything that you go for. Because in wrestling, you never stop learning. As soon as you think you learn everything, you need to get the hell out of the business.
Wow.
Get out. Yep, and I agree. Nobody knows everything about wrestling. You have so many greats. You got Mark Henry.
Mm-hmm.
You got Chris Jericho. Mm-hmm. You have so many
Team Malenko,
Jerry Lynn.
Jerry Lynn.
You have so many people you could
Big
pull
Show.
From.
I'm sorry.
The Big Show. The BS. No more BS.
No BS.
Whatever.
I love that, actually.
Yeah. So you're telling me you have all these people, and there's not even just them, but there's wrestlers that have probably been wrestling longer than you have and have more experience.
Probably.
You got the Hardys back there. And you're telling me that you can't learn anything from them?
You got people, a hell of a lot of people from the developmental system over there.
In NXT.
From NXT to, you know, the main roster, some of them, straight there. You tell me you can't learn nothing from not one man or woman from that damn system?
I can learn something at my job. I've been there for 11 years. If somebody comes in that just started yesterday, and they've been doing what I do longer than me, sponge. I'm a sponge. I'm trying to learn.
Yeah. Because
you can always learn. And even just from people, even if they haven't been doing it as long as I've been doing it, if someone has a good idea about something and it's good and it's legit and it pertains to our business, let's use it.
And he said that earlier this year. And it was like the audacity of this
that
guy,
is,
bro.
That's
what
wild.
Is wrong with you?
And we met Hangman. And
he said a cool dude.
That threw me off. Hey, I'm not gonna lie.
He said it before we met.
That threw me off.
When I heard about it, I was going, I hope he didn't say that, because that's dumb. But he was on like either a podcast or doing some kind of interview, and he said that shit. And like, the fact that that's amazing that like Punk remembered that dude, but he had time to sit there and stew on his feelings. So I get that, and it was like, yeah, I call him a fuckhead. Yeah. So like, you're a fucking idiot.
Yeah, and you know, and so probably why, I at least I could think why Hangman maybe feels this way is because the Bucks, Kenny, I mean all the Elite,
right,
they got to where they are, essentially. It was them as a group, collective, on their own, doing what they
mostly,
did. Yeah, mostly. I mean, but you know what I'm saying. Like, no one ever does anything truly on their own.
Right.
Like,
anybody self-made for real.
But a lot of the stuff they did it on their own merit.
Right.
It was them. So, I think that's why he feels entitled.
But and also, they brought him in. Too, though,
and they, and yes, they have the, I call it like the true pro wrestling fans. That's what I call it. It's not
kind of serious on those guys and girls.
Yeah, because it's not. Because it's not. Because it's not. Because WWE appeals to the masses. I feel like AEW appeals to like you love professional wrestling.
Right.
You're hardcore about it. We got you here.
Right.
That's what that is.
Right.
And I mean, for Hangman to just not think he can learn anything from people like you said that have come from WWE and other places. That have been to the have been to the mountaintop.
Yeah.
They've been to the mountaintop, to the top. I mean, look at Mark Henry, look at the Big Show, like look at the Hardys, look at everything that they've done. And you're telling
And you named three former champions, world champions.
You see what I'm saying? Look at everything that they've done, and you're telling me that you can't learn anything from them?
And all their pushes. Even though Big Show was like, Paul White. Like, when he was champion, it was cool. You know, it's not that memorable, but, like, he did it.
Yeah, and but Big Show was a wrestler that doesn't need to be champion. Paul never needed to be champion.
Right.
He was just, he just was him.
Yeah.
He was him.
And he was funny.
Yeah,
and
exactly. He was good. He was funny when he was funny. I feel like he had, like,
he was funny in Afghanistan when I met him.
Oh, yeah, I remember you telling me.
Yeah.
All aspects of professional wrestling, I feel like he can handle and do.
Oh shit!
Yeah.
Captain Insane don't show no mercy, bitch.
Yep.
So watch Water Boy.
Yep, man, bro.
But my question.
Yeah.
That wasn't even my question. I had to mention that when you mentioned it in the last episode. Yeah,
okay. Okay.
This is gonna be funny. What the fuck happened to Impact, dude?
What?
Cause I have it on Impact Champion. I mean Champion Channel.
That's the Impact Channel?
That's the Impact Channel. On, wait, don't you got a Samsung in your living room, right?
Yeah.
They have it. They have an Impact. They have an Impact channel.
What?
Yeah, I got it there now. I got it on my TV.
That's kind of dope.
Every time I turn on
my And I see there's like a, I don't know if it's like a subscription-based thing for Impact or what, but when I'm looking at Impact videos, because I look at Impact videos all the time on Instagram.
I miss it
and what it used to be, man.
And it shows some of those old matches from like 2005, 2006, 2007, and all that stuff.
They have some
and
stuff.
Older than that.
They got some stuff going on. I mean, it's not too bad.
Right.
I think it's just we're so far removed from it.
Yeah, man. I remember it was on Spike TV.
Because I'm not going to lie. I feel like AEW took Impact's place in what it represented. Because, TNA at the time was the alternative to WWE. And I remember when they were trying to go head to head with WWE. And
I hope it wasn't Hulk Hogan for real saying that shit.
What?
Like go on Mondays. Cause was that they played on like Wednesdays or something?
Yeah, they played
on
Wednesdays.
Like Wednesday, Thursday. No, it was like Wednesdays or something. Yeah. It was a time that was not slided from WWF for WWE. And dog, and it was good. It was good for what it was. I remember watching it. And then like they like we're gonna get some on Monday. It's like dog, y'all.
You better find something else.
And they did and failed miserably.
Yep, and it ain't been the same.
Yeah,
it ain't been the same since. I'm not even gonna lie to you. Like I like one angle that Impact has. I still try to keep up with it from time to time.
Yeah, no.
The Honor No More, all the former Ring of Honor people that are like a stable.
I don't know, I like that.
It's
that's
dope.
A cool
it's
dope. Name like that.
Yeah, it's dope. It's dope. I like it.
Oh wow.
But yeah, man, I don't know. I do like the fact that AEW and incorporate some people like Bill Morrissey.
Yeah.
Big cast for those that don't
John Morrissey.
Oh, John Morrissey.
Yeah.
Well, John and Bill somehow the same thing. I don't know
for you
in what world that works, but he's over there in AEW now.
Yeah, I like how AEW Impact, and New Japan. They all like work with one.
Yeah, like, and which is pretty dope.
The trinity of wrestling. Yeah,
it'd be cool to see WWE and AEW mix it up one day. I would love that.
That is a.
But I know it ain't happening.
That's like John F. Kennedy in Russia. Remember the biggest dick swinging competition?
Yeah. Oh
nah,
yeah.
Yeah, nah, we good.
Yeah, man. Let me see. What else?
Yeah, we're gonna nuke who first?
Yeah, I know.
We're going to shoot who first. Because
it's like somebody got to lose.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Like,
so
be,
that's all I got to say.
It'd be the Cold War all over again, bro.
Yep.
Nah, we don't do that. We ain't wrestling.
Yeah. So
Jesus Christ.
So I asked you about what you wanted from WWE. What's one thing you want from AEW that you want to see going? The obvious one is please fix this situation. Thank you. The obvious elephant in the room.
Oh, okay. Shit, this before this booking, bro. That booking is so schizo.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, my God.
It is.
Oh, my God. It is. So, you fix that shit.
Yeah, it is. It is. I don't understand.
I like them, but then, like, it's not consistent enough, dude.
And that's where it's funny because we just talked about Raw not needing to be 3 hours, but Dynamite or Rampage need another hour somewhere because it's so much stuff going on. You can't keep up with everything. Yeah. It's so confusing. Like, I don't get it. Well, it's like one day you have Darby Allin, you got Sting, you got these people here.
Right.
And then the next day, oh, you don't see them for two or three weeks. And it was like, what are y'all doing? Like, come on, man. Come on. And that's one thing I was going to say is a booking. Like, we need an hour somewhere. We need to put an hour somewhere.
Nah, I would say 3 hours for a Dynamite. Do it for Rampage.
Yeah, or if you're really going to use Ring of Honor, use Ring of Honor. Like, now, I don't know if Tony Khan, when he bought Ring of Honor, like, I don't know what that meant for all the wrestlers. Like, I don't know if they're all gone and never coming back. Like, I don't know. I don't know what that means. But if you can get some of them back, cool. But you got a huge roster.
They can use them on.
Put some of them over there. Like, you got some people in Dark Elevation that's
pretty decent.
Yeah. Put them on there. Like, do something. Like,
got a lot. And then, like, here's another thing, and like, I'm like, you know, I want to hear what you got to say, too. If you're going to tie storylines for, like, Elevate or Dark, I think it's mostly just Dark.
Mm-hmm.
Please show us what the hell you're talking about. But, like, they just mention it.
Yeah.
And it's like, well, I got shit to do. I'm not going to watch an hour of this on the internet. And they're really, like, quick matches. What I do like about Dark and Dark Elevation, when I do watch them, I don't watch them all the time, they just... It's match after match after match. It's a couple stories here. It's like one or two stories here. Match after match. Because I didn't know Joey Janela and Sonny Kiss was beefing. And like they had a match. And I was like, wait, they're tag teams or secret lovers. And then they started beefing. And they had a hardcore match. And I was like, we've never seen that.
Yeah, like, I don't know.
Like, that was TV.
Yeah.
What we doing?
That's weird. That's
what
weird.
What you want to see better or change or any of that good jazz for AEW, man? For
one thing.
The next... future.
Yeah, one thing is the booking. I do want to see something more consistent there because they do, and the crazy thing is that they do a good job at it, but they just have so many people that it just gets muddled and all over the place. I do want to see an additional hour or Ring of Honor incorporated into this. Like, I really, really need to see that. And then my obvious answer I want to say again, yo, bro, I need the lead, and I definitely need CM Punk to be back. And I need Tony to fix the mess that he made without knowing that he made it by being a nice guy. He needs...
I don't think they really need him because they got enough people. So, before you carry on, I'm going to tell you why. Because did you hear about what's going to happen for Wrestle Kingdom?
What's that?
So Tony going to send them guys out there on the...
Who are the Bucks and
No, just like your top guys to Wrestle Kingdom, which is the fourth.
Okay.
What day? The week of day is Wednesday. Yeah. So you losing your top guys when they're basically at WrestleMania in Japan, and now it's like, what do I do now? And even Tony was like, it's gonna be hard. But I'm like, no, it's not hard. I'm not even a wrestling booker. Even I can figure this shit out. What you do from right now until January, you fucking elevate your other guys. That's why you're like, you need these guys back. That's your problem now. You keep using the same guys over and over. And that gets old. Elevate the rest of the guys you got. You got the Jungle Boys. You got all these people. A freaking dog. I mean, you got
MJF.
Yep. Oh, I'm not gonna lie. Speaking on Jungle Boy, he kind of losing my they're booking him so great. Yeah. Like he got destroyed by Luchasaurus. It's like flip flop. He's a Christian. He's a Jungle Boy. Flip flop.
Well, and you know why, right? Because Christian was injured. That's why that was a squash match.
But why would you have? Why not let Jungle Boy squash Christian? Like, that's what you should have happened. Yeah. And then it'll be over and done. Because yeah. I haven't seen Luchasaurus in forever. You're probably never going to see him.
Yeah.
Did you see Christian? Real marks on him? Sizzling him.
And Jungle Boy got cooked. He was extra crispy.
Boy, you see his back, boy, grill marks.
But then, like, you got Dante Martin. That's a good guy that people like to see. You know what I'm saying? So many names.
Yeah, they have a lot of people. They can, like you said, now is the time to start doing that.
Elevate.
Start.
Jamie Hayter.
They're trying. No, her time's coming. Her time.
Yeah, but I'm just saying, like, so for you, well, not me, of course, they got a women going to Japan, but maybe, I don't know. But you have, it's September now, and that's what, like, what, you got, what, 4 months to January?
Yeah.
Yeah. Start elevating. Start. And I'm not talking about putting AEW dark elevation. Start booking your wrestlers strong. This ain't hard. This is easy. And Tony, you need help booking. Fucking get the help, or because you got like 10 jobs out. How's this your side job?
Hey, Tony, I'm just saying, you know, like this time Chad and Jeremy did a book, a fantasy book in the CM Punk. We kind of predicted some of the stuff that y'all actually did. So if you just really need some help, I mean,
what up,
Chad and Jeremy ain't doing too much. I mean, we got jobs and we'd leave immediately to go work for AEW. But I'm just saying. But yeah, man, bro. We could do this for like another hour. This is ridiculous.
We got to get out of here.
We got to get out of here, man.
We got shit to do.
But oh my God, man. Well, you know the vibes. Catch your boys on all the socials: Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, TikTok, Twitter. We out here, man.
Yep.
Thank y'all for the love y'all been showing us. It's been super awesome interacting with you guys. Even though some of y'all be getting kind of wild, but it's cool though. Hey, bring it on. We want it.
We ain't gonna talk to
y'all.
I don't talk to children or avatars.
CM Punk taught me. I had to deal with you children.
Yeah.
Hey. What about you, bro? What's up with this audio, though?
Oh, man, the audio, man. Straight up, man. Listen to us on Google Play or YouTube. Yeah. What's it called? Yeah. YouTube Music?
Google Podcast.
Google Podcast is the thing. Stitcher, Bullhorn, of course, Spotify, of course, iHeart, iTunes, or wherever you get your podcasts at. And, I will say about, you know, social media thing, like, we're not just mean kings out there. I notice y'all see our memes. It's like, Chaz memes, man, because he may be hitting them hard. I do a couple every now and again.
I'm a funny guy. I like to laugh.
He found a couple memes, he throw them out there. Sometimes he throw them more than I.
Yeah.
But, like, hey, man, you know, let us know what you think about the episodes or the clips that Chad works so hard to put together.
I'll be toiling away, man. Let me know what you think. This guy puts in a lot of work, too.
Yeah.
So let us know what you think about all our videos and everything.
Yeah, like, share, subscribe too, Jax.
Like, share, subscribe. Watch us pod in our glory, if you will. Because we've been putting in some work, man. And we're definitely looking forward to hopefully meeting some more of you guys at some conventions here in the Ace Town or other areas eventually when we get up and moving again.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. Well, thank you guys so much. Thank you, brother.
Sure.
Man, being the best podcast host of what can I ask for?
Man, I can't do without you, man.
Trying
to shine like you out here in these streets, man.
Be like you, shit, bro. You know.
Well, I'm going to do it backwards, man. I'm Jeremy.
And I'm Chad.
And this is Fusion High, and we out. Hi! Scoop douche.